interesting episode of Inside Out. And this week we have one of those, let me call them our relationship topics. And I'll tell you what led to this. I was in a room with a couple of ladies and they got around to talking about relationships. And there was just one guy, I think, in the room, like we have on our panel today. And one of them was complaining that she doesn't know what men are really looking for nowadays, that the men of today are very spoiled. They don't even know what they want. And so I said, let's call it, it's complicated. What does a man really want? Let me start with you, Funke.
The level of violence, cheating, breakups between men and women, 80% is actually from the main angle. You will say you're not complicated. You saw her the way she is, and you asked her out. Mm. After asking her out, 3-4 months, you now see that, okay, she is not the ideal.
What you are looking for.
Looking for. Then why did you ask her out? Is it that your brain cannot actually form what you really want? Or you're just out for adventure? Or you just want to take advantage of it? Most men try to hide underneath that, okay, is the women, is the women. But I tell you, if a man wants to stop dating a girl, he doesn't have to say a word. Action speaks louder. Mm. The call starts dropping. The visits start dropping. Then I am busy. Start taking off. Now, the girl in the other angle, being the emotional kind of woman, women that we are, now start taking like, why are you not calling? Now, they're not saying, she is nagging. Mm. Something that happened 3 weeks ago. The guy has been dating big girls, as big as I am. And he got married to a size 10 girl. And I said, what is happening? Is it that he just realized size 10 is a size, not size 16 or size 18? That means that he cannot possess exactly what he wants. I think it actually has to do with psychological and brain issues with men.
Yes, yes, please. I needed her intro.
I really would have loved to pick on.
No, you will.
Ah,
you
okay.
Will. Manage. Because she raised a lot of issues here. In fact, I hadn't even looked at it the way she's looking at it, to be honest with you. I've always had, my opinion doesn't count. Let me talk to you, Shibina. What's your opinion?
First of all, we have to ask ourselves the question, what does it mean to be complicated? Hmm. Complicated simply means not easy to understand.
Yeah.
And my personal opinion, I do not see the men like that.
You have supporters.
Yes, thank you very much. Yes. I see men as easy to understand because a man usually will tell you what he wants. For me, the women folk, I would say, are the complicated ones. And then I would I would say because for the women, most of the time as women, we have a mold we put the men into. Now, for example, a woman meets a man and the man is nice to her. The man has not said anything. He has not committed to you. Simply because he's nice to you, you assume that he wants...
So women assume quite a bit.
Yes, women assume quite, because they are very emotional. And because a woman is very emotional, she thinks family. So she assumes that the man is thinking on at the same level as she is thinking.
I'm sorry.
And it could just be that the man enjoys your company. He has not asked for anything more.
I'm loving this conversation. I want to get an overview. We haven't started just hold your point. Stanley.
Men are different. What works for man A might not work for man B, man C, or man D.
So human beings are different,
now,
generally.
I will start with myself. I don't know about any other guy. And I will tell you, I try as much as possible not to be complicated at all. Now, this is where I'm going at. I start a relationship, a serious relationship. I define to you what I want, where I am seeing this relationship. I ask you, are we on the same page? It's very complicated with ladies for me. I'll give you a typical example. I had a friend who was dating a lady, and the lady was loving him like mad. He was all nice. He was loyal, wasn't cheating. He tells you, I am so pleased. Lo and behold, he is there. And this guy got to an extent that, you know, the lady is coming to visit. He knows how to cook. He cooks for her. Do you know that part of what caused the breakup that she said was that the guy was becoming, he was behaving like a lady. Seriously. The guy was behaving like a lady. That the guy, okay, maybe she's come back from work and the guy now calls and says, so where have you gotten to? Hey, we're in traffic. Hey, sorry, hope it's not too much. The next thing she turned it to be was the guy was keeping a tab on her to know if she's in a guy's place or not. As innocent as that. I mean, for me, it is simple enough. The guy is just caring. The guy just wants to know what you're going through, what's happening in your day. And for me, that is complicated.
Let me talk to Priscilla Benjamin Olawale. I mean, you've been listening to this conversation. I noticed you actually turned, took a seat, listened to everybody. Mm-hmm. What's your view?
I need to help us with the understanding that a man and a woman are two different people that cannot be compared with one another. They are two parallel lines. They are different. It's important to understand the individuality of every human being. A lot of people go into relationship before what we call self-realization. They just stumble into it. It just happens to them. They are not adequately prepared. But when we realize that just the way you wake up in the morning to brush your teeth, take your bath, try to look good, that's the same way you should prepare for a relationship. So, sometimes we fall victim of certain pain and hurt because we have not done...
Is this women you're talking about, men or both?
I'm talking about both parties. Because we've not done our due diligence. We have not researched on what can a woman be like or what can a man be like.
This is what I want. And a man comes for me and you match up what I want. And coincidentally, the man asked me how. That, okay, now let's start dating. I want the man. He gave me all the green lights that I think is enough for me to know if a man wants a woman, I'm still saying it, he will get that woman. And it's just for adventure. There are some men that are just out for adventure. Yes or no?
Yes.
And they will go out there to get it. And I'm a woman.
But yes, I've heard that a man will go after, he will do the chase.
He will do the chase.
Whose responsibility then?
Not that I'm saying like that. Why is the man now coming?
No!
That's what I'm saying. Like that. Why is the man complicating the girl's life by shifting the girl's dream as a, I want you, and in his head, I'm not a god, I'm not a spirit. I can't open up his mind to say that, okay, he does not want me. He knows what I want, he knows
you
I
know
love
you. I understand what you said. I did a topic called The Chase.
Yes.
Some years back. Mm. And I asked the question, why does a man go through so much trouble
just
to get
a woman's
complication?
And then after he does,
at the end of the day, he just wants to fill up that loneliness of his life for a short period of time. I know a guy is out. You will not know.
I'm a female, but then I see that most times,
they say you're
women,
not.
Most times, women allow themselves to become victims. We are talking about generalization.
Okay.
They are signs.
When you say allow themselves, what do you mean?
In our society, there is a role, there is a way the woman is seen. So the woman grows up, the girl child grows up early, and she already has the pressure to settle in at a particular age. And because of that pressure, she begins to try to fit
she
into
told that she must marry.
Yes.
That it is wrong to be single.
She's already vulnerable. And then a man comes along. Why should it be me always wanting to do something for this man? Like what Fuke has been saying, the woman does this, the woman does this, then and then the man leads me on. In a relationship, even if a man approaches me and says, oh, Chidim, I like you, I want you to be ABC. Is it not my responsibility to ensure that I am not a doormat to this man?
Simple.
It is my responsibility as Chidim.
They said the men are complicated. The both are interwoven. They are both, they enter their self, but it's just that the one of the man is obvious. But as a woman, like myself, if I'm dating a man, I don't pretend. I go for what I want. When I'm dating you and I see that you're not giving me what I want, I drop you. That's me.
It is not when the breakup that has become complicated. The moment the guy is going for the lady and he knew in his heart of hearts that he does not want this lady, that is when he is a complicated guy. Because why do you want to waste your time and your resources on a lady that you don't even have any plan for? So for you to even think of it, you're already complicated. Like what she said, it's not until you steal that you become a thief. The thought that I want to go for this person, I waste my time, waste my resources, as long as you make it to be a complicated person. So that breaking up is just the physical manifestation of you being complicated.
If I say, give me one day of the week, I'd like to do Sunday every afternoon, and Sunday is a football match day. Meanwhile, Friday night is for the boys. How do you marry both? Where do you draw the line?
Cannot okay, fantastic. I started by saying that helping every individual understand him or herself. If I don't understand myself, I cannot articulate what I want. If I don't know that this is what I want. So the first thing is to say, what really do I want? You see, if you don't define yourself, other people will define you. The person who wrote that women want someone who would spend quality time with them, apparently that's that person's love language. Because oftentimes we speak our love languages. For the benefit of those who don't know, we have five. We have words of affirmation. That's people who love when people keep saying, oh, well done. You're beautiful. You look fantastic. Oh, you're intelligent. You just want people to compliment you. That's the first one. The second one is quality time. You love when someone spends time with you a lot. You know, you just want to hang out. Like Agatha said, oh, let's just hang out on Sundays. That's that person's love language. We have acts of service. You love when people just do things for you. You know, the woman, that's the kind of woman who will be in the kitchen and will want the man to come and, you know, even if he's not doing anything, just be there with her and, you know, help her do some things. Or if she's carrying anything, he wants her to carry it, you know, for her. And same thing with a man. He wants a woman who would wash his clothes, who would iron his clothes, you know, do things for him. That's his love language, you know, acts of service. The fourth is physical touch. We just love someone to hug you, you know, hold you and all of that. So acts of service, quality time, words of affirmation, physical touch and gifts. So first you have to understand your love language. So what do men want or what do women want? There is nothing like that. There is really nothing like that. There is only...
So that's the first thing is there's nothing like what men want.
There's nothing like what men want. Or what women want.
So what is it?
What is it is individuality. What do I want? As a male or as a female? I'm able to clearly define that before someone comes in. Because it's just like you wake up on a Saturday morning and you have no plan for that day. A friend will come along and says, oh, are you less busy? You say yes. Can you quickly see me off to the mall? You see that person off to the mall. Then you do some window shopping and that person says, oh, you've been with me all day. Let's just have a meal. And then you go into one of the stores there. I'm sorry, one of the restaurants there. You have a meal. And she says, oh, you've been good to me all day. Let me just make your day and let's watch a movie. Then you see a movie. Before you know it is 10 p.m. You have not planned your day, but guess what? Someone came along the line and planned your day for you. That's the way it works.
So, thank you very much to my wonderful audience. If I couldn't take your comments, I'm really sorry. Until next week when we come your way again, talking about something not so complicated. Bye-bye and see you next week.